why this water was sugar, I don't really understand. I was looking into the history of beekeeping. Manley, a British man, invented it. He said that honey was bad for bees. They had that sent to me, and there was a research from Germany saying that honey was bad for bees again. So we were better to remove it all. Except for 5 kilos. I also find that even if you are a good winning beekeeper and you're trying to genuinely do the best for your bees, as I did, it's just impossible. Because the country has changed a lot, apparently. I just arrived to the UK 5 years ago. I haven't been here for the last 300 years, so I don't really know. I can explain that this is what has happened. We are mainly like a 70%, 79% agricultural country. That means the land is shaped in a way to feed the human needs. So what happens is that most of the Scotland is moorland and peatland, where we do have heather, which is a plant that actually has honey, but it's only in August. And when depending on the weather, some years it might not happen. And where we have sheep, the sheep really eat to the bottom of the grass, and not all the time there's going to be much for the bees. There's something, a particular type of clover that we seem not to use anymore, but if we will use that, it seems that the sheep cannot really get so to the bottom to eat this clover. And that has disappeared from our agricultural traditions. So suddenly, all this land that used to have something good for the bees can have disappeared in the past few years by the use not using clover. And then we have lots of land used for grass. Grass is something we harvest 3 times a year, so the flowers don't have time to grow. So it's not good for bees, and we devote all that. Then we have a little bit of a forest, which is, this is cereals. This represents wheat and barley. And this at the bottom represents forests that are mainly coniferous. So see this yellow line represents something called oil rapeseed, which is a crop like barley and wheat. Actually does have a flower, because barley and wheat, apparently the bees don't get any nectar or any pollen from it, so it's not used for them. All this looks like nothing to them. But this yellow flower, oil rapeseed, there's something on it, there's nectar on it. But the problem is that oil rapeseed has 22 pesticides, and one of them used to be the neonicotinoids. And this plant, this neonicotinoid, is now banned in Scotland, and it has been now allowed again in 4 counties in England. So it's good, we don't have neonicotinoid just now, but we still have 22 pesticides. And then the conifers are good for bees. So we just have a little bit of trees, this yellow line that is toxic, and then we have some gardens or the urban areas that represent 3% of Scotland. And then we have heather in August. So actually, there's not so much. Depending on the region of Scotland, of course, we are actually quite a big country with lots of difference between the east and west coast. So this is just, remember, it's an average. But I have been beekeeping in Office and Galloway. We are a region where we don't have trees, where we don't have crops. We have actually lots of fields for cow and sheep. I think we had good chances to have a good yield and a good, it seems to be a good place to do honey. Well, even though in our case in Offaly and Galloway, the yields have dropped, and they seem to be around this 55, so 55 pounds, 10 pounds for the bees, or 11 pounds for the bees. And the rest for trying to make a living. Making a living on beekeeping is extremely hard. You have lots of expenses. If you want to have your own equipment for extracting, and then you have to pay as well premises monthly, it can be a lot. You have lots of driving, and so to make it work, actually, financially, and I can understand why this change on a Scottish landscape has had an impact on the way we have to do things. I think if you have a family, you have kids going to the university, your wife is pregnant, you know, you are trying to pay a mortgage, you are trying to survive, and this is going on, you are just trying to save your family and do the best for this family. But I just wonder, is there any other way we could make it work for our families and for the bees? Something that is actually more balanced, because I think that by using water with sugar and bringing the bees to harvest this oilseed, because oilseed actually can give you lots of honey. But what we do is that we put the bees in a lorry and we bring them to the oilseed field so we can have more honey that we can sell out. And because we don't have anywhere else to bring them. And we need to create spaces where we can actually bring our bees that are not poisoned. There is a debate about the impact of the pesticides. Some people might say they don't have, but I just think that there is not enough research done in the proper way. Sometimes the research is paid by the people that's actually producing the chemicals. So, and also it's done on a short term. And the last thing I wanted to show you relates to how are we trying to survive in terms of our bees are dying. So basically, we are having losses, and the way we are coping is that we are importing bees from Europe. So I was speaking to a man thinking that he will be importing bees from Spain. Then we are importing bees from Italy, and sometimes when they run out of bees over there, they can come from other parts of Europe. And also, when you buy bees from a certain person, this person can actually speak to other beekeepers and help